I see you have red lines here. You don't. I've not really seen those outside London. I'm not sure if they have cameras. They've spent millions, one would assume. But then you'd have to have a central station to monitor that, so they probably haven't got cameras along here. I cannot see any.
No.
But double yellow, or double red lines, is definitely a no-no for parking, as you know. Let's go across the road to get run over. As I said, you know, 3 years crossing this road, not used to traffic coming along here. The tunnel is not open yet, obviously, because the trams are not running, so that's why it's probably still very quiet for the cars. So yes, you should rename it the Golden Almost Half a Mile, I think now, but most of the clubs, yes, are closed here. Some nice Indian restaurants along here. Dil Bar, we featured in one of my videos. The owner's finding it difficult, but hopefully it will get better soon. You know, you can see over there and here. You know, get rid of all this. I'm being fastidious. Rubbish surrounding these shelters here. It's just so unsightly. I've had it for over 3 years, guys. Get rid of it. But it is amazing. And where we end up, they had, you see Cineworld over there? Yesterday, they had some sort of demonstration. Perhaps someone could educate me. I didn't look it up. There were about 200 to 300 people outside, and the police yesterday saying boycott Cineworld. I'm not sure why. Something was going on. They knocked down some flats here and offices. Quite nice, to be honest with you. Now you've got this going on possibly 3 or 4 years. But they can come through here, as you can see by the roundabout. So it's just they are not aware it's opened. It's been so long. But that's it from almost from Grand Central, where we started. And it's wonderful to see Broad Street. So we just have the trams to come under here, go under the bridge here. Morrison's just the other side, and it's a couple of hundred yards on, and that's where the holdup is at the moment. But it's imminent, because I didn't expect all this. I said a week ago you had 10 ton of building materials here. Can they go? Let me just show you. Oh yes, sorry, look, bus is coming and I'm in the road again. So yes, the cars can come here. It's just a tunnel, so it's only going under the tunnel. Five ways roundabout, St. Martin's Place. We have featured Made in Ireland, and then they put them together like a Lego set. Down this side, for example, listen to this noise here. Would you want to listen to that if you lived in one of those flats there? This road down here is really, really noisy. You've got the other side of here, which is just a brick wall, and when they open this completely, a very, very 24/7 very noisy road. And just a couple of weeks after they opened St. Martin's Place, they started building this. which is possibly 3 or 4 years. So would you want to live there? It's only 14 floors. It's owned by the people who own the hotel just here. And the other side, you've got nothing really, it's just a brick wall. If you look up here, as I said, they came on the back of a lorry from Ireland, prefab made. You go from the first ground, first, second, fourth floor. You see the fourth floor there? You see this? They have a major problem there. With dampness. Major problem. They've had those dryers hanging out of the window for 6 months. If you look at the side, they've got some really, really thick insulation, so they have a serious problem with the flat on the first, second, the fourth floor. So just be warned. And those huge dryers, and the whole walls are just covered in really thick insulation. So they have a major problem there. They're trying to dry it out with dampness. I suppose they cannot just take the section out and get another one, obviously. Nice reception area, cinema, small gym, 14 floors. Charge about £1,150 for a very small one bedroom apartment. And as I said, you've got all this building noise and this road. I wouldn't recommend it. And I did look at several there. They do have a raised garden. I think it's the third floor and they have patios. That is really nice, I have to say. So you could live in the middle of here, behind all this. It's like a third floor raised garden area, and they have patios. And I think it was Martin's who I saw. Absolutely useless. Just quickly look, electric bikes now. See this one where it's got the purple? There's only one here at the moment. Go online and download their app. It's not cheap, it's £150 to take it, and £6 an hour for an electric bike. I think that's a lot of money. And if you are with a partner, you will be paying £99 to take an electric push bike out, which is outrageous, I think. £99 for the whole day. It's just ridiculous. The non-electric bikes, they are hard work. That would cost you half, so half of £99, rule of thumb for the whole day. So I don't think, you know, I would take a... I'm thinking of just going for a quick cycle ride, trying them out. I have tried electric bikes before. The one I wanted, Colmore Road, there's a... next to the 200 edition coffee bar, you have a cycle shop, but £3,000 is outrageous. I mean, £3,000, I don't think I would ever pay £3,000 for an electric bike to get some exercise. It was fantastic, but that's outrageous. Apparently they're all made, almost all of them, in China, and there's an incredible markup for them. Shipped over here, so it's difficult once you've got them to get spare parts for them. You might get a personal service from the shop you bought it from. It's a good cycle shop in Colmore Row. Can't remember the name, but it's almost next door to 200 edition coffee bar. So they build a substation here, just over there, for 6 months, maybe 9 months, dug up everywhere. But it is coming together now. Let's be positive. So we have left where the trams finished. They cannot go under the tunnel, but you can go either side, coming in and out of Broad Street now, which is wonderful. But as I said, most of the traffic, I should not think they are aware of it at the moment, certainly car drivers, because it just happened this morning. So it's as if we would have come under the tunnel with the trams from Broad Street, I showed you by the cinema, and it's all finished. But the hold up is where I'm going to show you. Morrison's around here, been a building site for several years, so it's wonderful to see. So yes, and the thing about electric bikes, as the owner said of the shop, never leave it. He said it doesn't matter how much you pay for a padlock, and you can pay a couple hundred pounds, he said they will get it. So it's purely for exercise. You wouldn't be able to, say, put a box on the back, go shopping, go to a park. You know what it's like when you go out cycling, you want to just padlock your bike and leave it somewhere and go for a walk or go into the shopping centre. But you cannot do this with a £3,000 bike, because as he said, they will get it and take it, he said, so I never leave it unattended. So it really would be purely for exercise. I just think that's too much money. They're grossly overpriced anyway. So yes, this has been a building site, the most horrendous for several years. Nice footpath. You can see these look clean because they are new. I mean, where you saw all the grease I showed you, it's where they had the takeaway restaurant. You see there, they would come under the tunnel there. It's all ready, all finished. I came up here last week, and I'm going to be presumptuous, but you probably see nobody working here again. And yes, you had two people here just standing around, nobody doing anything, and it looked like they had, this is where the trams would go, looks like they had a month's work. That was about 10 days ago. So not too far the trams stop up here. Thing I like about the DJI, have a look online, it's 4 inches tall. Put it in your pocket. I have a extension lead. It's got a much better zoom on it than the iPhone 11. Picture quality is probably the same, to be honest. Sound is better, would you believe, on the DJI, but it's got 4 speakers. I bought a very special, only £30, separate microphone for the DJI, and that's even better. So here you are, look. Very busy, sitting down on their phones, of course. Sorry, forgive me, I'm being naughty. I don't know what I'm talking about. So if you work here, forgive me. So you have this area here, look, which is going to take a while, obviously, to do. Let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, we have 6 out of 8 people not working, so I suppose that's a good average to have 2 people out of 8 working. Behave yourself, Bernard. So it's all this area, as you can see here, but they could still open the trams, and I'm not sure if they would. But nobody's working on there, and no, so it's over there. I'm not sure the grass there, you see, but that wouldn't take long to cut. And this is where they were doing quite well. I say doing quite a lot of work, but nobody's doing anything at the moment, but this is the only reason I can see why it's not open now. Have a look. That's it, just there. And obviously all the footpaths here, I can't imagine they're going to leave the footpaths like this. But nobody here. 6 weeks and 3 days. Oh no, it was 7 weeks, wasn't it? Hello. So when do you think this will be, the trams will be running through here?
I think they plan it to be, it's not long to go now.
Yes.
That's already, but this one, this is going to be put on like, we all guys going to be finished today from here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to be done today.
But this is going to take, what, a couple of weeks, this?
Yeah, it's for the bus stop.
Yes.
Friday.
And,
but,
and...
Well, I think they're going to be very soon now. I'm reckoning it might be a couple of weeks.
You haven't got very long, Commonwealth game. No?
Well, Tom, they're just finishing bits and bobs now.
Yeah, but they've got to do all this footpath as well, haven't they?
Yeah, all the footpath, yeah. I think it's fair that we're all going to be done as well.
So you could be looking at 3 or 4 weeks. But
that's going to be a long job because they're going to be extending this tram line to all the way as well.
But the trams obviously are not running because of this here. And they stop here.
Yeah.
But, you know, you start running into July, you're always on top of the Commonwealth Games.
I think that this has been done now.
Yes.
So we're going to be putting this whole stuff up from here today.
Mm.
So, yeah. By that time, it's going to start running.
Yeah, you've got to. You'll be in trouble. Because they open Broad Street today.
They open it here?
Yeah, go under the tunnel.
Under the tunnel, yeah.
It's all open. And vehicles can go up from either side now, buses for the first time in what's over 3 years, isn't it?
Yeah.
And that's wonderful to see.
I'm hoping that under the bridge, that's going to be opening soon as well now.
Shouldn't it?
Yeah, everything has been done there now.
And the thing is, although the trams are not working, which annoys me, they've got all that awful, all the barriers around all the bus stops where the trams would stop. Just take it away. I mean, they've got an announcement there saying it's not operational at the moment. Take it away. You know, it's been awful to look at for 3 to 4 years.
I think if the barrier's there, it's just for a reason. There might be some work going on or something.
There's nothing going on at all. Honestly, it's because the trams would stop there. And they probably think, oh, well, passengers might be waiting here for trams. But it does announce, because you know the tannoy system by the bus shelters?
Yeah.
It is actually working. It's telling people it's not operational at the moment. I'm getting impetuous because I've lived here for 5 years and I come along. And I think when I went along to Broad Street this morning, I was so happy to see it open. Hey, we've done a wonderful job. Well done.
That's everything that's been done there now.
Yeah.
They're planning to start these tram running very soon now.
Oh, good,
yeah,
good.
Very soon.
Thank you very much, anyway, for all your help.
Okay.
I'll send you a Christmas card.
Yeah, thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye. So that's it, guys. A little bit of information for you. And now you know. Now you know. So, hope you enjoyed the video. As I said, I was going to keep you informed. Look forward to going on a tram from Grand Central and look forward to coming along here when the trams are running. Take care. See you soon. Bye-bye.